Well, regrettably, some people do use SHA-1 still, but of course we're trying to deprecate it as quickly as possible. So there's a couple of issues, right? It's 160 bits, which is quite long, right? This means that the chances of you stumbling across two messages that hash to the same thing is about 2 to the 80, roughly. Now, 2 to the 80 is still a very, very long time, right? Somewhere around 12 million GPU years or something like that, I think was estimated recently.
In a brute force.
Long enough that even the NSA won't be doing it, right? But the problem is that the compression function of SHA-1 is not so good that the attacks are 2 to the 80. They can be reduced somewhat to about 2 to the 60, something like this, which is becomes into the realm of possibility for people with a lot of money, right? People not like me, I should say. But it comes into the realm of possibility for people with enough money and enough server power. So there's really no reason, apart from if, for example, your message size is very limited, there's really no reason not to move to SHA-2, which has been around for a long time and is almost exactly the same as SHA. It's got a slightly different compression function and the internal state is longer. It's 256 or 512 bits. So, you know, then your starting point is trying to brute force something like 2 to the 128, which is a huge amount more than 2 to the 80. Right, and a much, much more than 2 to the 60. So even if you find that the same weaknesses exist in SHA-2 as exist in SHA-1, it still might not be brute forcible for a long, long time. So, you know, the strong recommendation is for situations where you're using SHA-1, you want to start moving towards SHA-2. You know, not, I mean, don't panic and do it, you know, quickly now and make and introduce lots of bugs into your code, but, you know, over the next year, just start phasing it out as quickly as you can.